Hi guys, we were talking about trigonometric ratios for a few specific angles. So last time we saw, our table looked something like this, where we had seen the values of these ratios for 30 degrees, 45 degrees and 60 degrees. Now in this video we'll see what are the values of these ratios for 0 degrees and 90 degrees. So let's go to our triangle. So let's say this is triangle ABC, right angled at B. So B is 90 degrees and we have to assume that angle A is 0, since we are looking for 0 degrees. So let's say that for now angle A is some small value, say it's 10 degrees for now. Now what we are essentially doing is we are rotating this AC about this point A, and we are trying to get C as close as possible to B. When that happens, we would have AC looking something like this. Point C would come here, and this angle, angle CAB, would go on reducing. So only this angle between the arrows would be left. So when C comes much close to angle B, we would have angle A as 0 degrees or almost approaching 0 degrees. In that case, if it is a very minuscule angle, we would still have triangle ABC, which would be right angled at B. In that case, we would have the length BC almost equal to 0 and AB would be almost equal to AC. So let's see if we can find out the ratios. Let us assume that AB and AC were A. So sine of angle A, which is sine of 0, would be the opposite side upon the hypotenuse. So the opposite side was BC, and we've seen that BC is going to 0. So this is 0 by hypotenuse was AC. Let's take it as A. So sine of 0 degrees would be 0. And similarly, cos of A would be cos of 0 degrees. This would be the adjacent side for angle A, which is AB in this case. So AB, and AB was equal to A. And upon the hypotenuse, which was AC. So even this was A and AC was also A. So we would have cos of 0 degrees as 1. So we define sine 0 degrees as 0 and cos of 0 degrees as 1. Now once we have these, we can find out the other ratios. So let's fill up the table that we had. For 0 degrees, sine 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. Tan 0 would be sine 0 by cos 0, which would be again 0. The inverse would not be defined, because anything divided by 0 is not defined. Similarly, cosec would also not be defined. And finally, sec of 0 would be 1, inverse of cos A. Now let's see what would we have if we had angle A as 90 degrees. Let me redraw the triangle. So let's say this is A, this is B, this is C. Angle B is 90 degrees. And we have to also see that angle A should go to 90 degrees. So how will that happen? When the point A starts moving towards point B along this line, at some point when A is very close to the point B, say somewhere here, we would begin to see that this line CA is almost perpendicular to AB and AB is almost zero. In that case, this angle, angle CAB, would be 90 degrees. So when angle A is approximately going to 90 degrees, we would have AB as 0. And we would also have BC, this line, equal to AC. Let us assume that BC and AC are A. So, sine of angle A, that is sine of 90 degrees, would be the opposite side, that is BC, by the hypotenuse, that is AC. So, this is BC by AC. And we see that BC and AC are same. So, sine of 90 degrees would be 1. Let's look at cos of angle A or cos of 90 degrees. So, this would become adjacent, that is AB, by the hypotenuse, that is AC. So, again, we have the adjacent side as going to 0. This would be 0 by A, and hence cos of 90 degrees would be 0. So, we define sine of 90 degrees as 1 and cos of 90 degrees as 0. So, let's fill it up in the table. Here, we had sine of 90 degrees as 1 and cos 90 degrees as 0. So, tan of 90 degrees would be not defined. And similarly, cot of 90 degrees would be 0 because it would be cos of 90 degree by sine of 90 degree, that is 0. So, cosec 90 degree would be inverse of sine, that is 1 again, while sec of 90 degree would not be defined. So, this is the table and finally it looks something like this. It's ideal for us that if we remember the entire table. And it's pretty simple. I know it looks very scary. It used to look very scary to me at least when I was in my 10th grade. But now over time, I think it's pretty simple. What we need to do is, we just need to remember the first two rows. And it's actually simple. You just need to remember only sine. So if you remember sine, you can invert it and write cos and the other ratios. So sine of 0 degrees is 0, sine of 30 degrees 1 by 2, sine of 45 degrees is 1 by root 2, sine of 60 degrees is root 3 by 2, and sine of 90 degrees is 1. And if we look carefully, this, if sine is like this, cos is similar like this. So 0 comes here, while 1 comes here, root 3 by 2 comes here. So it's just diagonally opposite. If you just put sine of 0 as 0, then cos of 90 would be 0 and cos of 0 would be 1 because sine of 90 was 1. So, this is just diagonally opposite. And once we know sine and cos for any angle, we can find out tan by just dividing sine A by cos A. And similarly, cot would be cos A by sine A. Cosec A is 1 by sin A and sec A is 1 by cos A. So, it's pretty simple after this. So, we just need to remember the first row and we can find out all the other ratios. So, we know that if the angles are given to us, we can find out the ratios of the sides. But what if we are given the ratios? Then also, we can find out what the angle would be. So, it works in both ways. So, ideally, it's best to remember this table. We'll look at a few examples in the next video. Bye.